Hello, Mystic Thumbs users. I'm going to run you through some of the basic functions of Mystic Thumbs as quickly as I can and try not to make a mess of it. Now, we've installed Mystic Thumbs and we have everything currently enabled, so we've got some basic thumbnails going on here. We've got a number of file types, PNG, PSD, DDS, ZIP, Target. And you notice before you install Mystic Thumbs, the reason why you've come to Mystic Thumbs is because a lot of your thumbnails are going to look like icons like this, which really don't do much good at all. You've got the file name to go by, but there's no actual image, and Mac users will tell you what's going on. Why don't you get an image? So this is why you've come to Mystic Thumbs. So here we go. Let's go to the control panel, which is opened by double-clicking the diamond, Mystic Thumbs diamond, in the system tray here. That opens the control panel where you can adjust pretty much everything you want. Now what we're going to do is first enable all file formats. And that's done by selecting this option here. It's three modes. First mode is drilling down to the extension level, Photoshop document, and then the supported extensions. Second mode is just the file format itself, which applies to all extensions under that file format. And the third option is all file formats. It gives you a warning to indicate that any changes you make from there on in are going to apply to everything. So let's just go with Photoshop documents for the time being. So that will apply changes to just this one file here. They're enabled. Just change the transparency, for example, the checkerboard light. Now, this is a default. You're changing default options in the control panel. When you apply a change, it doesn't necessarily apply to any of the folders you have open in Explorer, and that's because it just doesn't know what's open and what it needs to refresh. So if you want to refresh after you've changed a global option in the control panel, you can right-click within the window, choose thumbnail, and say refresh, and that will refresh everything in there. Now you see that the Photoshop document has become checkerboarded, as we requested. Another way of doing this is to use either an individual file by selecting it, multiple files by selecting multiple files with Control and Select, and then using the thumbnail menu options by right-clicking. Now, in this case, we could say make them all transparent or make them opaque or make them dark checkerboarded, for example. Or just simply refresh. Again, if you right-click in the window and choose, say, default transparency, it will reset everything in that window back to its default options as specified by the control panel. In the case of PSD, checkerboard light. In the case of DDS, let me press this, type in DDS, direct to a surface, enable it, transparent, and so forth. Let's just go ahead and enable all file formats now. And also icon mode. Icon mode, press apply. Icon mode is when you're in small icons, details or list view, when they're 16 by 16 icons. Now that enables the thumbnailing to happen when they're in icon modes. So just disabled it. Re-enable, apply, and there they go. Now, all file formats, let's just make everything the same. Let's make everything checkerboarded transparency. Apply that, right-click in the window, thumbnail refresh, and here we go. They're all checkerboarded transparency. Scale up will Let's say we go to extra large icon mode. See, this is a small image, and it's smaller than the icon size that Windows is requesting, which is a 256 by 256 icon. If we apply scale up, scaling images to requested size, actual size, or scale up. If we apply scale up, then again, we'll need to refresh this window. You see that it now scales the smaller images up to the requested size, so they all look consistent. Personally, I prefer to keep them the actual size by default. So we can do that. Refresh. They're back there at default size. And if you want to make any particular icon change to something, you can select those. See, there's three smaller icons here. We can right click on those and choose a scale up option, which will just apply to those three images. Now, here's an option which I didn't speak about in my last video. You notice that when you have a file format, it's associated to a particular application. In this case, we have DDS, or Direct Raw Surface Images, associated with DirectX Surface Viewer. If we double click that, it'll crash, apparently. But let's pretend it didn't crash. That's applied to Direct Draw Surface Viewer, which is a bit flaky, obviously. If you want to, you can just go to File Format Mode, DDS, and we want to change the icon to something else. Now, immediately it's suggested the DDS file format icon. Now, MysticThumbs will automatically select the executable, if one exists, that is associated with that file format, and give you all the icons available within that executable. Alternatively, you can select another DLL or executable and select the icons from it if you want to get very specific. Now, in this case, we have the default DirectX yellow X on a blue background, or we have a DDS file type icon, which is used for documents when you're creating those images in some file, some application. We can choose that. I press apply, and you'll notice that Explorer automatically changes the file type icon to DDS there. Photoshop document, same deal. Search by extension, type in PSD, Adobe Photoshop document, enable icon mode. Now we can choose an icon. It's automatically selected it. It's getting smart. It's automatically selected the, there's the default PS icon, which is not much use. It's just kind of open Photoshop, but we can actually make it a PSD icon. Of course, Photoshop, the executable has all these different icons in it for the different file formats. And we can select that one. Uncheck this. This icon here means, if that's enabled, it means you're specifically saying you don't want to see an icon at all. Remove it for that file format. But we don't want to do that. Press apply. And you'll see Photoshop document will suddenly appear with the PSD icon in the bottom right to help you discern which ones are Photoshop documents. The other option with the icons are to bin any change. The reason for that is if you select any icon from wherever, it's actually storing that icon on the system and using it as an offline cache. If you bin the icon, it will remove any association at all, and it will go back to default. In this case, it's not associated. So just reapply and show the Photoshop icon. PNG, let's try again with that. PNG, bottom network graphics. That's the default icon, it's not enabled. This is the global enable. We use this option here to disable all icons on everything, not just MysticThumbs enabled formats, but it will disable or enable icons on everything across the system. If you don't like them, you can use that to just disable the icon overlays and clean up your thumbnail views. Let's leave them enabled for the time being. Photoshop, portable network graphics, PNG, go to an icon, and this is the options. It's selecting from integer.dll because it's a system defined icon type. Now we could use something completely random, like we want something that looks like an image, right? So let's say that and apply. And then PNGs will have that icon overlay. Don't want it. Finish. And apply again. And throw it away. Okay, so we're going to now quickly look at changing different file extensions to look different. This is a icon customization. You see we've got this these two amulet.psd and psb files. Let's just remove this here to make things clearer. In fact, let's remove all of these other images for the time being. So let's see what we're doing now. If we go back to the control panel and bring up Photoshop document, we've applied an icon change, as you saw before, to the whole of the Photoshop document range, all file extensions. So each one, PSB and PSD, are both showing a PSD icon. Now we don't really want that. We want to make the PSB icon a PSB icon. Now, the way of doing that is to disable this checkbox to apply all changes to the file extension level, and we can now select PSB. Alternatively, keeping that disabled and pressing the loop, we can type in PSB, and it will automatically take us to the right file format. Now, you can see that icon is set to this PSD icon. Now, if we open the change dialog, you can see all the icons in Photoshop.exe, and we can find PSB in here somewhere. There it is. Double click that, PSB, and apply, and you'll see now you get a PSB icon instead of PSD. Now that's some intensive customization, but if you want to, you know, that can help you really discern your slightly different file types. Now, even though both of these are Photoshop documents, one is PSD and one is PSB, and that can be useful. Okay, now we go to the quick view mode of MysticThumbs. Now this is a similar implementation to what the Mac has. When you press space on the Mac, you get a quick look view of an image or whatever the file is. Now, in MysticThumbs supported formats, you have to press control space and quick look comes up. You can then start using the cursor keys to move backwards or forwards through the files in that folder. Generally, you can just select the file in the folder and automatically update the quick view window. Now, let's have a look at this file here. Now, it likes to keep the initial size of the window. You can resize the window if you like using the grab handles. And all the normal modes of MysticThumbs are adhered to: transparency, scaling, filtering, scale up, etc., etc., pre-mod reply, and so forth. Now, in the case of this image, it's a smaller image than the current window size, which we can adjust. The reason it's staying the original size is because the default for the file type, which is DES, default is to not scale up. So we can manually just change that by right-clicking within the window. So now it's scaling up to fit the window, keeping the transparency checkerboard, which you can also change, of course. And it also uses the sampling mode, smooth, or bilinear filtering, or nearest or point sampling. That's very useful for game artists and so forth if you want to look at pixel perfect images instead of having the bilinear filter applied. You also have conversion options. Currently supported are icon, PNG, and TIFF. You can do that within the Explorer window by going to thumbnail convert. So they're quite useful if you've got whatever file format that MysticThumbs supports and you want to convert it into a portable file format, icon, PNG, or TIFF. Okay, a few quick tips on using Windows Explorer with MysticThumbs to get the most out of it. In Windows 7 and Windows 8 is slightly different, but you see pretty much the same thing. At the top right of Edge Explorer window, you've got the size of the thumbnails you want to view. That's handy. You've got list mode, details, which shows you all the columns you want. MysticThumbs supports a lot of tags that you find here, like dimensions, for example. Let me show the size, not tags in this case, just the size of the images, sort by that. Use the column, sort by highest size to lowest size. In this view, small icons. Remember, small icons are enabled and disabled through this option here in the control panel. And you can do that on individual file formats as well. Of course, anything that flows down from here applies to everything that has gone before it. So all formats, enable, disable, small icon mode enable, associate enable, and so forth. So all the different types for each file. Icon apply. And then you've got the global options, so click view. Process priority in case you've got a slow machine, enable and disable the tray icon. You generally want to keep that enabled. The thing is, there is a background task for those administrators or well-known Windows users out there. Changing that does not kill the process that runs in the background, which if you open up Task Manager is the MysticThumbs.exe process you'll find there. It pretty much stays resident to handle the viewer, quick view, and background tasks like checking for dates and so forth. So it won't actually disable or kill that task. It just enables or disables the tray icon if you don't want to. Okay, so let's have a look at thumbnails on a desktop. If you've got some transparent images that you want to keep on the desktop, so this one here, let's move it across the desktop. There it is with the current settings applied. Now, there is a global option to make desktop thumbnails always transparent, regardless of whatever settings the file or the image type is set. That's this one here. Now, it's already enabled, but we just moved it across the desktop from our folder. So the thumbnail is cached. We can quickly just refresh it. And there you go. It's now a transparent thumbnail. Again, if we disable that option, apply, and refresh again, all thumbnails on desktop will not be transparent. It's a nice little addition, just to have some, you might have, who knows what, on a desktop, do you want to be transparent? That's a pretty useful option. If you're like me, you like to keep the icon overlay disabled as well. Use that option there. And there you go. Nice, splendid icons on the desktop. You can even control, command, Windows. Is it? No. No, it's not it. Alright, holding control key and scrolling your mouse wheel increases and decreases the size of the icons on desktop. It's something that's not very well known, not advertised very well. Quite handy to set them to a nice comfortable size level depending on visibility abilities and so forth. There you go, thumbnails on the desktop. Okay, so let's play around with a few other Explorer options. Let's try preview pane. This is Windows 7 again. Windows 8 might be slightly different, but you have a preview pane. You can enable that. And pretty much whatever you've got selected shows the maximum preview size that it can do in that window. And we can adjust these things so we can fit our icons in nicely. We have a vertical scroller there just showing our previews of things in that window. You can, of course, anytime change options on something. So, and the tree and scale it up. And make it a dark checkerboard. No, it's not good. Dark checkerboard. And you get the point. Now, of course, you've got a quick view. Well, beyond that, where you can request the light. Let's disable preview pane. We've also got on the bottom, which is the details pane. Depending on the image type, you might get extra information. So, for a camera, you get ISO. Aperture, shutter speeds, and so forth. Depends on what sort of metadata you have in that file. MysticThumbs has a lot of those.